Holy Spirit, we will never be the same.
This kingdom does not run by brute force. Amen. It runs by wisdom.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. And wisdom is the tree of life. Hallelujah. Amen. That means that when I do things by the wisdom I've received from God, it's not only that he will give me a breakthrough, but that breakthrough will keep feeding me. That breakthrough will keep strengthening me.
Amen.
That breakthrough will make me wiser. I believe in Psalm 119, the psalmist, the young man said that even the law of the Lord has made him wiser than his teachers.
Yes. Amen.
Wiser than his ancients.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I keep using this building as an example because there's no place to go read the manual to do what you have witnessed. It was done by the wisdom of God. The wisdom of God will make you take a clean sheet of paper and create a world.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hey, glory to God. Now, when I said that, I mean, I just got blessed. He rained on me. And the next thing that came to my mind, if you think about a blank sheet of paper, where did God get the materials to create the earth?
Amen.
Have you ever thought about how many granules of sand that's on the earth?
Amen.
You can't count them.
Amen.
Where did God get it?
Come on now.
He says, by wisdom.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Come on, lift your hands and say, Father,
Father,
in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
May your wisdom
rain upon me
that I may know the answer
to every issue,
every situation,
every
problem that must be solved.
I receive
the answers by faith as I hear this message. May the Holy Ghost minister to my heart and give me revelation and open my eyes and show me mysteries. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Glory to God. All right, Proverbs chapter 3, once again. Happy is the man that findeth wisdom, and the man that getteth understanding. For the merchandise of it is better than the merchandise of silver. And the gain thereof then fine gold. She is more precious than rubies. And all the things thou canst desire are not to be compared unto her. Length of days is in her right hand. Immediately you see that when our lives are cut short, it's because of lack of wisdom. He said, wisdom in her right hand is length of days. Hallelujah. In her left hand, riches and honor.
Amen.
That means no believer should be broke.
Amen.
The wisdom of God should populate your mind and give you creativity.
Amen.
When you understand what I'm teaching you, you will never run from pillar to post chasing what you already have. I've seen pastors running up and down, chasing success, running to this meeting, trying to connect with some big name. And I asked them, where did the big name get his answer from? I said, whatever I need will come and meet me at this altar.
Amen.
That's the wisdom of God for me.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Length of days in her right hand. Riches and honor in her left hand. So By the wisdom of God, I can confidently declare that all of us will live long. Yeah. Hallelujah. That's a thunder from the throne. Every spirit of untimely death just left this room. Glory to God. Hallelujah. That was a bullet from the throne. And demons took flight. Hallelujah. In the same measure, I declare that all of us will enter riches. And honor. Hallelujah. Okay, now, if you watch closely in America, every time somebody discovers something that will make money, every Tom, Dick, and Harry will just jump into it. Because people are chasing after money. Both the called and the uncalled. Okay, Nigerians, hold your stones. Don't throw. I tell Nigerians all the time, you don't have to be a nurse or pharmacist or a doctor to have a breakthrough in life. Because so many people are in there for the money. They're not called to it. How do I know? If you studied history, and then all of a sudden now you're doing nursing. Is the money driving you over there? Amen. You don't even love people.
Hallelujah.
That's why we have all these angry nurses at the hospital. I said, girl, I didn't do it to you. The money you are chasing. Don't come here trying to mess up my veins. I went to do one physical. Here is the physician's assistant. And she couldn't find my veins. She said, you know, that happens, you know, once a day. I said, I should not be the guinea pig. I said, hey, there's a nurse over. I said, hey, nurse, come here. So she came and touched her, and then she stepped away, and the nurse found my my veins immediately. I said, see, now that's the call. This is a phony here, you know. They came for the money. you know, I'll get over there, but you see that Satan is teaching a different doctrine where the word of God is teaching another. He said, wealth, riches come by wisdom, not by the degrees. The wisdom of God will lead me to the right profession for me. And you know it's the right profession for you. Because when you get in it, the anointing rests upon you as it rests upon me preaching. Ooh, hallelujah. Everything you touch prospers. You know you're in your right calling because God will be working with you. He'll be answering you. He'll be showing you what to do. That's why wisdom is the tree of life. You are being fed as you work, as you labor. Watch, listen carefully. What is feeding you through what you're doing? God is revealing himself to you. The creativity of God is coming to you. We are not called to chase money. We are called to chase God. Listen to the text. He said, blessed is the man, happy is the man that findeth wisdom. In other words, you should pursue the wisdom of God. While people are chasing money, you are talking in tongues. You are reading your word. You are waiting on a supernatural download. Amen. You wait on it until he comes. And when he comes, you get all you need. Hallelujah. Amen. When God spoke to me, get up and start your ministry. Everything I needed downloaded into my spirit. That's how I know what is what and who is who. Resurrection is in my spirit. I may not know 1, 2, 3, 4, but when I see it, I know it. Hallelujah. Amen. So the man is blessed when he finds wisdom. So all the time, people waste chasing after things. No, that's the time you need to be chasing the wisdom of God. Amen. Because it will catapult you to every breakthrough you're looking for. He said, the merchandise of it is better than that of silver and gold. As I said last Sunday, when you discover the wisdom of God, it motivates you to action. When I was preparing, the Holy Spirit gave me this line. Let me find it. I wrote it here. He says, are you operating by wisdom or by emotion? When you operate by emotion, you are busy, preoccupied, but you achieve nothing. Amen. When you receive the wisdom of God, it moves you to action.
Amen.
I discovered that God loves to hide things. Yes. But he says it's the honor of kings to search it out. If you're a king, then you will know that it's your honor to wait on God until he shows you the secrets.
Amen.
I've told you all, no matter what your profession is, Jesus Christ, the revelation of Jesus Christ is hidden in it.
Amen.
You're supposed to discover him.
Amen.
If the church had been taught right, we would have won the world long ago. Because every time you encounter a believer, you start discovering the mysteries of God. You know that you've contacted an excellent spirit. Not just somebody like you making noise because they go to church. But if something happens, everybody's behind it hanging out. Nobody has the strength not to blow up, not to get angry. Happy is the man that findeth wisdom.
Amen.
And the man that get it understanding for the merchandise. See? You seek God until his wisdom comes. Then you seek him for your next steps. What did I discover? All that process of obtaining wisdom and knowing what to do is where all the grace you need is inculcated or put in you. You receive the strength. You receive the understanding. You receive the discernment. Everything you need is put in you. You're not supposed to be looking for things on the outside. They are downloaded in your spirit.
Amen.
Now watch. You have a segment of Christendom that don't believe in the charismatic expression of the Holy Ghost. But they're saved.
Amen.
But watch, they say, you know, there's no speaking in tongues. That went out with the apostles. But yet the Holy Spirit is in them.
Amen.
Is in there. Everything you need is in your spirit.
Amen.
The answers are already in there. When he came in to you, he came in loaded. Hallelujah. When I understood these things, I stopped chasing anything. I said, hey, it will come to me. That's the way what I'm telling you that just came to me. I wasn't feeling well, and this thing kept going up and down. And I told Doc, give me some antibiotics because I'm tired of this fever flaring up. I don't feel anything. But I kept reading my word, and then I couldn't concentrate. And then finally, I said, no, I'm going to bed. As soon as I said, I'm going to bed, boom, he came. I knew immediately what to tell you. About 2 o'clock this morning, He comes. But he always waits for you to wait for him. Amen. Hallelujah. You have to spend time looking for it. All right? Look at Proverbs 2. I'll show it to you. Look at Proverbs 2. My son, if thou will receive my words and hide my commandments with thee, so that thou incline thine ear unto wisdom. See? And apply thine heart to understand. Watch it. Yeah, if thou criest after knowledge, you have to cry for it. If you cry after knowledge and lifted up your voice for understanding, if you will seek her as silver and search for her as for hid treasures, then, in other words, if you haven't put in the time, if heaven inspects you and you haven't cried for it, you haven't labored for it, you haven't put it above anything you're pursuing, amen, they won't respond.
Amen.
Listen, I know you come to church every Sunday and God blesses you and you receive. You don't know that I am more amazed than you. That I've been preaching to you for 20 years. Nonstop. And never lack what to say. That's a miracle. Yeah. And always a fresh word. Yeah. When I see preachers sweating, I have so many unfinished messages. Go to the library. You see them writing their sermons. And sweating. And I'm preaching to you with no notes.
Amen.
Week in, week out.
Hallelujah.
Why? I'm prophesying from my spirit. He deposits it in me. And I just relay it back to you.
Amen.
But while you're running the streets, I'm on my knees. Heaven has to see your cry. So when you cry for wisdom and lift up your voice for understanding, he said, if you search for it as you search for treasures, silver, gold, he said that God inspects you and looks your ardent pursuit of money, and then you compare it with your pursuit of wisdom. If your pursuit of wisdom does not reach the level of diligence and pursuit for money, he won't respond. He said it has to be commensurate. Your pursuit of wisdom and how you work hard for money has to match. Otherwise, God will not respond. Because wisdom is more powerful than money. Glory to God. Everything I'm doing is teaching you resurrection, but you're still too independent-minded. But when you grab a hold of it as your lifeline to your breakthrough, to your generational blessing, hallelujah, you will listen to every message. You will make notes for yourself. You will teach it to your children and their children. And you create a generation of African Americans free from the mentality of slavery. You become sons of God in America. You are prosperous. You are able to do anything. If God weighs how hard you work for money, and then he looks at your labor in his word and how much time you spend waiting for him, will he respond? That's why he told me, don't move on.
He says, that's when you will understand the fear of the Lord. And then you will find the knowledge of God. Then he makes it plain. Look at it. He says, verse 5 again. Then shalt thou understand the fear of the Lord and find the knowledge of the Lord, knowledge of God. For the Lord giveth
wisdom.
Out of his mouth cometh knowledge and understanding. He laid up sound wisdom for the righteous. He's a buckler to them that walk uprightly. He said he lays up sound wisdom for the righteous. It's God that gives wisdom. I mean, there's so many scriptures we'll be touching in releasing this tree of life in our life. But we have to get this foundation right. I'm going to keep saying it. I'm not going to preach long. We might end before time. Wow. Because I want you to hold on to this. If God examines your pursuit of money and your pursuit for wisdom, of wisdom, would you make the grade? Because he says, if you don't match it, at least, how hard you work on your job, at least, look at so many of you, like the ones now, they've gone to college, then they went to medical school, and now they're going into residence. Look at all the years it would take them to become a doctor. But then you carry around our Bibles and invest no time in it. Let me help those of you that are not in the medical field, that your own profession don't pay as much money. Don't join them because you are not called to it before you kill somebody. Wisdom will deliver to you more grace than any profession naturally can give to you. The wisdom of God will come down and show you something.
What a word, beloved. What a mystery. What an understanding. Wisdom is the tree of life. The Father sent back the tree of life to the earth so that we will start experiencing eternal life now. Who ever knew that? It's been there. We've been reading the Bible for years and never saw it. It's the tree of life. Did you get that? He says, your pursuit of wisdom must at least equal your pursuit of money. But when it exceeds it, you got it made. It says, you shall find the knowledge of God. You will understand the fear of the Lord. He gives wisdom. He lays up sound wisdom for the righteous. He's a buckler to them that walk uprightly. Riches, honor come. Hallelujah. When I see the amazing thing sinners have done, they start something very simple and it becomes a $1 billion thing. And then the Bible says we're blessed with inventions through wisdom. And the church, by and large, is broke. Very few people have money. And then when people see people that they think they have money, everybody goes after them and is clawing on them, trying to get. That's what I'm going through in Africa. One lady said, oh, you're my mentor. I said, where did I even know you from to have mentored you? You're just trying to get money from me. Glory to God. But what you're looking for way up there is right down here. If you learn the wisdom of God, God will lead you to your own breakthrough, to your own oasis. You will cross your own Jordan into your own promised land. You will fight the wars of conquest. Hallelujah. That's why my conference is named Conquest. Amen. They're taking territories for God. When I see what's happening across America, I'm just amazed. All the laws being passed to protect the Judeo-Christian principles of the Word of God in America. Checking these liberals. I hear that people are now exiting California. Yeah, because it's chaos. It will happen to New York too. Chaos. Ignorant leaders. You cannot ignore the word of God and win. You're going to end in confusion. Everything will fall apart. The Bible says that everything is held together in the Lord Jesus. Everything falls apart. When you see these wicked nations, these evil, godless nations, and they're coming up strong and they look like they're really going to do something, you have to know that it's because God needs them to fulfill his counsel. It is still him. It's still him. Even though he allows the devil to get the job done. You see how woefully Russia is doing in Ukraine? It's the prayers of the saints wearing them out. They're so frustrated, they just reposition some nuclear weapons, threatening to use it because they're losing. They're losing big. Jesus is the Lord of glory. He is the King of kings. He is the Lord of lords. He is the bright and morning star. He is the soon coming King. Amen. Learn the tree of life and start living by it. Reject the tree of knowledge of good and evil. Wisdom, wisdom, wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom. In all thy getting, get understanding. You can sow your seed also. Ask him, Lord, what seed do I need to sow to release the power of your kingdom in this area of my life? He will tell you. Obey it. Don't listen to naysayers. Our miracles and breakthroughs is a testament that what we're preaching is true. Amen. Receive grace in Jesus' name. We love you, beloved. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye. When dead things come.